Hey, what is up guys, MKBHD here, and as you know, we've talked through the leaks and rumors of the next upcoming iPhone over the past couple weeks, based on what we know. And as you probably remember, every year our confidence level as we get closer and closer to September gets higher and higher as we feel like the phones are already being made and we basically know what we're about to get. And that is around now where we're starting to get these physical representations, these models of what we expect to get, the stuff the case makers use, and the stuff the curious can actually look into. These are the iPhone models. So this year is no different, except for the fact that this time we have more than one. We got a couple. So from the same sources as last year, which turned out to be pretty accurate, this is your in-depth look at the new iPhone, the physical models. So first of all, I'm calling it that because we still don't know what they're actually gonna be called. You could go with the iPhone 10 Plus or the 10S. The big iPhone, the little iPhone, whatever you want to call it, we still don't know, but it looks like there's going to be three iPhones launched in September in three different sizes. First off, we are getting a refreshed iPhone 10. So same size, 5.8 inch display, same design, same price. You pretty much know what's happening here, but the newness will be in updated specs, and it'll most likely come in a black, white, and a new gold color. Then we have this larger iPhone 10 Plus, you might call it. This one with a 6.5 inch display. So it's a massive version of the iPhone 10 we already know. Bigger OLED display, bigger battery, just everything about this phone is like the current one, but stretched out. This will probably also be in black, white, and gold as far as colors available. And the tough part is imagining the price, because we already know the iPhone 10 starts at $1,000. I can only imagine this larger iPhone 10 Plus will start at like $1,100 or $1,200. But still, hey, you know me, big hands, big phone. I'm definitely still gonna be all over this one. But then last but not least, we have a second model, which is somewhere in between the two in size, a 6.1 inch display. And then there's a couple key differences with this one, which we'll call the iPhone 10 Lite. I mean, it won't be called that, but that's what we'll call it for now. First of all, this is the one that's expected to have an LCD display, not an OLED like the other two have. Generally, LCD displays aren't as good as OLEDs, but again, Apple's had some of the best LCDs in the past. And then this one's also expected to come in a bunch of new colors. Some reliable sources have said at least four new colors, which would be awesome. Still looks like a glass back though, as you can see, it's not plastic, but you can see it also has a single camera on the back instead of two. And so with all these differences, it's supposed to start at a lower price point, maybe around $700 to $800. Definitely not a budget phone by any means, but $200 to $300 cheaper, I still think warrants calling it iPhone Lite. Still has Face ID, still has Force Touch, still has all the other features of the $1,000 iPhone 10, except the OLED display and the dual cameras. Plus you get some color choice. A lot of people tend to think this lower price is going to make the iPhone Lite or whatever it's called the best selling of the new iPhones. I tend to agree with that, although it's not as clear cut as you might think. There's a lot of things Apple's doing to make it feel and make you definitely know this is the cheaper one, but I'm still hoping for some good colors, maybe a red and a blue and an orange at launch. That would be cool. But here's some other things you might not have noticed or heard yet about the hardware. Obviously, the major thing is the notch is the same size across all these phones, so don't expect to see Apple making a smaller notch this year. This is more of an incremental refresh. Maybe in 2 years we'll see that, so yeah, brace yourself for another year of phones with notches. But the thing is, on the biggest iPhone, the notch does kind of feel a little bit smaller just because the screen is so huge. So technically your screen to body ratio is a little bit better, and I'm kind of feeling that. But in the grand scheme of things, there is really less than one diagonal inch separating the biggest from the smallest. So even though it kind of looks and feels huge next to the smaller iPhones, some of you might remember I talked about how huge and ridiculous the iPhone 8 Plus was. This new iPhone 10 Plus will still be smaller than that iPhone, just a little narrower, a little bit smaller, but will have a massively larger display, one extra diagonal inch of screen. And with a little After Effects magic, that can help us really appreciate that difference. Other things I'm noticing, just as I'm holding them, the camera module is still kind of huge on all of these iPhones, even the Lite. Even though it's a single camera, it still sticks out the back a lot, it protrudes. And the flash is also outside of the camera module, which is interesting, but I still just kind of wish it wasn't so gigantic. And you may also notice the bezels on the iPhone Lite feel just a little bit thicker, just a little bit. And the body of the phone feels a little bit thicker too, just enough to notice it and have it feel less premium, I gotta be honest. So again, it's just a little couple subtle things like that that are gonna make the LCD iPhone feel a little less premium than the OLED ones. There's also a new rumor that this LCD iPhone will have Face ID Generation 1. And these two new OLEDs will get Face ID Gen 2, which may be faster or more secure or some things like that. Also, and this may be super minor, these new iPhones appear to be white while the old ones look silver. It's just a little bit brighter. But that's, again, something you'll probably only really notice when they're next to each other. I actually dig it though. The white feels cleaner. But that is it. That's the most reliable version we have now of what we expect to be Apple's 2019 smartphone flagship lineup. Nothing too shocking here, obviously, at all. I am really into the idea of the bigger iPhone though, which is weird because I've said before that the current iPhone size versus the screen is great, but I've used so many bigger phones lately and it compares so well to some other big phones I've used that I'm really excited to finally have a big iPhone screen like this. This will be the biggest iPhone screen ever. But what do you think? Which one would you end up getting? The biggest phone with the biggest price? Or the smallest phone with the current iPhone size? Or do you fall somewhere in the middle? Feel free to let me know in the comments section below. Or even better yet, feel free to share this video for those who are curious about the future of the iPhone, soon to be revealed in September of this year. Either way, until the next one, thank you for watching. Talk to you guys later. Peace.